Amy Donahoe has surfed some of the world's biggest breaks. However, the former CT star had one of her most exhilarating moments in the water this week when the local surf teacher found herself staring into the eyes of a great white shark.
Oh, look, we're talking a couple of arm's lengths, so, like, you know, no more than 5 feet away. So I think such a unique experience to probably one of very few people that would, you know, be able to say they've seen a great white shark up that close. Just such a surreal experience, really. Not something that I'd expect. You know, I've lived here and surfed here for, you know, 35 years, and it was just a phenomenal experience to see, but also quite intimidating.
The incident occurred at McMaster's Beach on Monday.
I'd surfed all morning on Monday, had a really nice surf, and after lunch just decided to go back out for another little paddle, and so I was sitting on the Suck, which is the furthest point out on the point here, which is quite a fair way out, and I was out there with one other surfer, Steve, and it may have been looking at us as potential, you know, prey for some time. And he was really lucky. He was looking at a wave, and as he's looked at that wave, I know I'm paddling back out, just looking at him. And as he's looked at this wave, the shark's breached, the teeth are out, and he's seen it exactly the same time I have. And then we've both just turned our boards and beelined straight for the rocks. Obviously, you know, in that moment, adrenaline's going a million miles an hour, and the last thing you're worrying about is anything but just getting yourself up onto some sort of dry surface to get out of the water.
The Hawaiian Triple Crown winner escaped relatively unscathed.
Feet are like, you know, they're shredded to bits at the moment, but like, you know, in the scheme of things, and I didn't even feel it, like we talked about the body experience, there was that much adrenaline that I didn't even feel it. It wasn't until I well and truly got up to the top here in the surf club and some of the other people that were around said, "Whoa, you okay? You okay?" And I was like, "Oh, there's blood everywhere." So yeah, started to sort of have the replay of what happened and actually thinking how the severity of what could have been and how lucky I was not to actually have something, or even and Steve have something happen to him.
As to whether or not Donahoe will get back on a board, well,
you know, surfers like to act all tough, and I'm one of them, and say, "Oh, you know, we're going to go back out there and everything's fine." But in the back of my mind, after seeing it and just how ferocious can be, I'm definitely just a little wary at the moment. At the end of the day, I'm a shark lover, and it's you know, they're scary, but it's their home.
Amy's GP, a local surfer herself, gave her some sage advice to heal the trauma.
So her technique was grab a box of chocolates, go back down to the beach, replay the vision of witnessing the shark, and, you know, eat a chocolate and try and replace that. I guess it's what some people would call some sort of trauma, isn't it? So it's like it's getting those good endorphins and replacing the memory of something positive. Good chocolate. Let's hope chocolate fixes everything.
Sky Hull, Central Coast News.